I got a message the other day asking me my thoughts on the math manipulative called Numicon. Now, I've never actually used that particular math manipulative, but it got me thinking about what I would look at while I was using it to decide if I thought it was a good manipulative to have my kids use. I'm Christina Tondevold, the Recovering Traditionalist, and today we're going to take a look at evaluating math manipulatives in our quest to build our math minds so we can build the math minds of our students. Now, really, you can go buy whatever math manipulatives you want, but when we are all really scarce for time and money, I think that it's really important to make decisions about what you're going to spend your time and money on to help your students build their math minds. So here's three things that I tend to look at when I am trying to evaluate a manipulative and see if it's something that I want to spend my time helping my students learn how to use it and figure out ways to bring it into my curriculum and lessons, and if I want to spend my money on it as well. So the first one is, does it help kids see and build relationships around numbers? You guys know my big thing is number sense. And so those manipulatives, I want to have them give kids the opportunity to be able to see relationships. Now, counting is a really big thing. It doesn't matter if you're first graders or fifth graders, kids will be counting whatever kinds of numbers they're working with at the time. Kids need to count. But we also want to allow them, while they're counting, to be able to see relationships. Here's an example in the early grades that I really love, and that is a Rec-N-Rec. Some people call them math racks, number racks. The Rec-N-Rec allows kids to be able to count one by one to show an amount, but also if I say, you know, show me six, and they do one by one by one, and they get all six over there, once they've counted the six, I can now have lots of discussions about what do you notice about six, right? And things that I hope that they see are that it's one more than five. It's got four left over here. Well, what does the four left tell us about the number six? Oh, it's four less than 10. There's so many other things that kids can learn about a number with this type of manipulative versus just just normal counters, right? They could count out six things and it won't tell them as much as it will if it's in something that has a kind of structure that allows them to focus on relationships. Another big one is the Cuisenaire rods. Cuisenaire rods use a lot of focus on relationships. So you're looking at this rod in comparison to this rod a lot of times, right? I can delete that. Or maybe in comparison to this rod, what do you notice? What do you wonder about the green versus the gray, right? So anything that is focused on relationship building, I feel like is a great math manipulative. But one of the things that does bother me about Cuisenaire rods is that it doesn't allow kids at any stage to really work with them. And that's tip number two. Does the manipulative help kids be able, or allow kids at any stage to be able to use this manipulative? Now, I'm not talking like, if I bought this for first graders, could the fifth graders use it? Right? Like a Rec-N-Rec. I would totally use a Rec-N-Rec in first grade. It may not be something I use for fifth graders, but if I buy it for my first grade classroom, could all of my kids in first grade have access to that tool? And one of the problems I see with Cuisenaire rods, let's say I grab the green rod. I don't know what the green is. How much is the green worth? Let's say I'm adding the green plus the purple. There's nothing there for me to add, right? I mean, you can. One of the things that you do is you take the single cubes and you add them on here until you, you know, figure out what they are. But for a lot of kids, that becomes extra steps that kind of get in the way. Annalise Record, who is a facilitator inside of Build Math Minds, loves Cuisinaire rods for the younger kids. But my personal preference is second grade and up. I want kids to have those opportunities to see the individual items and to build relationships at the same time. But Cuisinaire rods are wonderful as kids start moving past that counting stage. And they're also awesome because you can use them as kids progress into work with fractions. I love Cuisinaire rods for fractions as well. Which that brings us to tip number three. What's the return on investment? You want a high return on your investment. If you're going to spend a bunch of money on manipulatives or the time it takes to bring manipulatives into your classroom, I want to make sure that you get a great return on your investment. So if a manipulative really is only helpful for one thing in your math year, I don't really know if it's worth the investment, unless that one thing is a huge part of your grade level standards. For example, Rec and Recs really just help with number sense and addition and subtraction. Like, you don't use them for place value. I mean, a little bit in the teen numbers, you can get ones that extend up, but the standard one that's just two rows, you do a little work with teen numbers building it, but it's more number sense, addition and subtraction. But that is a huge deal in kindergarten through second grade. And so to me, it's totally worth it because you're going to use it almost on a daily basis because that is the world you're living in, is addition and subtraction, building number sense, and place value up through 20 is really the focus in those grade levels. Things like pattern blocks you might think are just for geometry and like identifying shapes, so it might not be worth it, but you can also use pattern blocks to have kids sort and count out amounts. You can also share them with your upper grades teachers, and they can totally use those for fraction work. So I want you to really think about all the ways that a certain manipulative could be used to help your students and really focus in on what's going to give you the best return on your investment, whether that investment is money because you're buying the physical objects, or if you've noticed, the ones I've been sharing are virtual. There are a lot of virtual options. And so if you don't have the money, you can use the virtual ones, but you're still having an investment of time. It takes time to put this out there and get the kids logged into things and to the right website and everything else that's involved with using manipulatives. Even virtual manipulatives take a lot of time. So I really want to make sure that it's helping build a solid understanding of a lot of standards so that it is worth your time and money if you're going to actually purchase the physical manipulatives as well. So again, my three things that I take a look at are, does it help kids build relationships? Can kids at all stages use it, like at your grade level, no matter where my kiddos are at, could they still use this manipulative? And is the return on your investment high? So in the comments, let me know what's something that you look at when you're evaluating math manipulatives. All right, I hope that this video helped you build your math mind so you can go build the math minds of your students. Have a great day.